M4 Business and Sandra Fenice here. Sandra, you take it away.
Hello, I am Sandra Sinamafeni. Good evening, and I'm here for business. The Bank of Ghana would next year set 2% of commercial banks' reserve to finance small businesses. Governor of the Bank of Ghana, Dr. Ernest Addison, disclosed this after the policy rate was maintained at 16% for the fifth time. There's more in the following Business Desk report.
Given more details about the scheme, Governor of the Bank of Ghana, Dr. Ernest Addison, noted the initiative is part of the enterprise credit scheme announced by the Finance Minister, Ken Ofori-Atta, in the 2020 budget.
To also support and strengthen the growth of credit to the private sector, the Bank of Ghana will explore the possibility of setting a minimum loan-to-deposit ratio to ensure that more deposits mobilized by banks are channeled to viable private sector projects. The Bank of Ghana will hold further consultations with the banking industry to determine the impact of such a regulatory measure.
He also rejected arguments that this move is against the Bank of Ghana's own free market regulatory approach. He also announced that they are working to scrutinize the compensation packages for chief executives, board members, and key management staff of banks.
To ensure transparency, banks will be required to publish value-added statements disclosing details of the compensation packages of key management personnel and board of directors separately from the total employee compensation.
Commercial banks are also expected to come out with frameworks that would impact on borrowers' credit profiles. On the recent banking sector cleanup, the governor also announced that the two receivers have so far been able to recover a little over 1 billion cedis. Dr. Addison also disclosed that it has given GCB the provisional license to issue the ECD in the near future as a bank. This is part of the broader role of digitalized economy that the regulator is working on.
GCB cannot create money. They are only having an electronic representation of the CDs that Bank of Ghana puts into circulation. So it is not crypto.
From the governor's announcement, it has also emerged that mobile money accounts of its more than 30 million subscribers.
Meanwhile, economist Professor Peter Korte is supporting the decision by the MPC to maintain the rate.
In the past couple of months, we haven't seen much significant change in the level of economic activity to warrant a change in the policy rate. You also look at exchange rate depreciation. In the past couple of months, we haven't seen much depreciation to call for a change in the policy rate. You look at inflation and inflation expectations. We are within the single digits. We haven't seen much change, a significant change in the rate of inflation or people's expectations about inflation in the future for you to revise the policy rate. So all of these factors put together will call for the policy rate to be maintained. A downward revision in the policy rate is also not good because there are other market players, a lot of foreigners who own our bonds, our locally denominated bonds. Now, if you reduce the policy rate, interest rates, they will exit the market, and that will lead to capital flight that can have severe repercussions on our exchange rates. If you recall, in March, April 2019, we had that situation where the policy rate was reduced and there was capital flight. It is indeed justified. For me, it is that an upward review is not justified, and it's also not in tandem with government policy of ensuring lower prices, lower interest rates.
So I want to stay more on the story, and this man here needs no introduction. But if you're joining us for the first time, he's our in-house researcher and analyst. He's Philip Namfuri. Thanks so much for joining me. As always, it's a privilege having you.
Yes, please.
Now, we are being told by the BOG that they want to set 2% of the bank's primary reserve to finance small businesses. First of all, what is this primary reserve?
Okay, so
what does it entail?
Thank you very much. So anytime an individual or a business makes a deposit, Bank of Ghana has set in place what they call minimum reserve requirement. So 10% of your deposit has to go back to the Bank of Ghana.
Okay.
So if I go and deposit 10 Ghana cedis, one Ghana cedis is kept in reserve by Bank of Ghana. Why would they want to keep a reserve? So that in case, all things being equal, if there's any unforeseen pressure in terms of a run on your bank or some unexpected withdrawals, you have that money to fall back on as a bank. They also do this to more or less ensure that there's a reasonable level of money supply in the economy. So it has implications on Bank of Ghana's own tools for controlling inflation and other things. Mm. So this is one of them. So in the week, or on the average, weekly, banks are supposed to take 10% of each person's deposits and go and put it at the Bank of Ghana.
Now, and if nothing, you said in an event where something happens, then they fall on that. And if nothing happens, what happens?
Then the money sits with Bank of Ghana. Okay. That's it.
It doesn't go back to the bank.
It doesn't go back to the bank.
Okay.
So Bank of Ghana wants to tap into this as a support of government's enhanced credit scheme, the ECS that the Minister of Finance announced in the 2020 budget. Mm-hmm. And when the Minister of Finance was talking about it, he says, "Mr. Speaker, we would like to emphasize that the ultimate aim or the ultimate solution is for job creation. The ultimate solution, I beg your pardon, Mr. Speaker, we would like to emphasize that the ultimate solution to job creation lies within the private sector." Mm-hmm. And he goes on to reference how we are growing at over 25% and how others are growing at 5%. Mm-hmm. And he says one way to support them is to ensure reasonable level of lending rates. Mm. So Bank of Ghana is trying to tap into this virtually, and I use the word advisedly, unused funds, so that banks can channel these funds to SMEs. And the funds will sit to the Bank of Ghana. Any bank that participates in this scheme that will be operational from next year, from the finance minister, will come and tap into this fund to support SMEs. And you know, SMEs globally have critical challenges. The paramount one is funding. If you check World Bank data, over $2.6 trillion funding gap of both formal and informal SMEs globally. In sub-Saharan Africa, the problem is about 55%. So that's why there's a push to help SMEs because of their critical importance.
Okay, so Philip, this will be probably called the direct lending and subsidies, subsidized interest rate for SMEs. But you know, a lot of international development institutions such as the IMF have actually frowned on this because you're supposed to create an environment for small businesses to grow, but not give them direct. So is this the way to go, especially when these institutions frown on this app?
I like where you've gone with this. Is this the way to go? There's a critical question we need to ask here, or answer here. Enabling environment, we should put in structures, and the governor mentioned some of them, the high non-performing loans. Mm. What are some of these causes? The operational inefficiencies of banks, they are working to address them. What should we do to put financial institutions in a position to lend better, rather than stepping in and doing direct lending and then subsidizing interest rates, like you said? Mm. The debate can go on, but like you rightly said, some of these international institutions, IMF, I remember I've watched a video somewhere where they are opposed to this type of thing. The environment should be created for these things, for these financial institutions to lend to them. So we can go on with the debates, but government also has, on one hand, a business of wanting to support businesses, small businesses, growing the economy. And look at the importance SMEs have in our economy. 92% of the businesses are all SMEs. Their impact on employment generation, etc.
Right.
So it's all about weighing it and see what is good for us and what will work. But I hope this scheme will be done in a manner that doesn't dole out money to people who don't really need it or not.
All right, Philip Namfori, I guess we have to leave it here. We'll talk more on that. But that's how we wrap up for the first half of business. When I return after 8 p.m., I do have a lot of business news for you.